Alright friends, so we got another short video here. This one's going to deal with duplication and how duplication and cloning works in Lychee. So the first thing I'm going to do is just going to go ahead and drop a support here. This is the Grinning God from Archvillain Games, from their Circus Grotesque October release. So right now we're in the classic mode and I have just dropped a support. So right now I'm not selected on anything, that's why the model is gray, and when I hover over the model the support is orange. When I click a support, if I'm highlighted on it, it will turn white like this. And in any mode, if you're highlighted on the support and you hit the Alt and D button, you duplicate that support. So I can then just pick and grab and then move the support. Now you notice that it kept that support together. It stayed all part of it. So if I go to move it again from the tip, it's going to stay connected back to this joint. I can move it wherever I want. Move it up over to here, and you notice it's staying connected to that joint. Now, if I grabbed from here and moved, will it let me? It will not let me because of how I cloned it. Oh, no, there it went. So even in classic mode, it just depends on where you grab, and that's going to determine how it moves. It's going to try and draw it from wherever you were. Now, let's go backwards a little bit, back to our original. So that's still there. It's cloned. Now we're going to go into advanced mode. You notice how there's that sleeve over the support? I'm going to go back one more step. Now there is... Ooh, I think I'm hitting the right go back button. My computer is fighting me. There we go. Alright. So in advanced mode, that's just one support down. When you clone a support, you notice now it has that sleeve over it. That's your visual cue to know that this support has been cloned. Now again, in classic mode, you can just grab the support and drag it and it will remove. But in class or in advanced mode, that's not the case. It depends on where you grab it. So if I grab from just the tip will move. If I grab from this ball joint, it'll move from the ball joint. If I grab from this ball joint, it will move out from that ball joint. But you notice it stays connected at the next ball joint or at the next section. Unless it's the third joint. And in this case, we've got 1, 2, 3. This is the third joint. That's why it moves the bottom skate. If this joint were all the way down here, like this, and this joint were, let's say, down right here. Let's move these guys over so that it all matches so you can see what I'm talking about. Okay. If I move this ball joint around, you notice it doesn't change from there. And it doesn't move that bottom skate. If I move this third ball joint, let's move this up, and then move it around like this, you notice that it's not moving it either. So it's one of those interesting things with, it depends on where you are and how it will move it. But everything is editable. And with cloning, it just depends on where you grab. So let's say I want to clone. Let's make a... little guy like this. Now this is going to happen sometimes when you clone things or you're making big giants. So I've got this weird support like, how do I use that? So you notice here on my base tip, my length is like way wonky. All I got to do is just drag that down and it'll redraw for me and shorten things up. Oftentimes when you get a weird support that's kinked in weird ways, go to tip and base tip diameter and you'll notice that your lengths will be super long. Just drag those back down to something reasonable, and then you can more easily move things around. So we've got this support that we've cloned here. Now, I'm in classic mode, and I just cloned it again. And I can just click and drag. Clone, click and drag. Sometimes it's fastest to clone in the classic mode. Other times, like let's say I don't really want to move much, and I'm just going to be doing all kinds of stuff in here. I'm going to stay in advanced mode. Because it's just easier to just, I only want to move this tip. And I don't want to, now if I were in advanced mode, or classic mode, and I go to move this tip, notice how it's moving the whole support, and I don't want that. I also wasn't cloned, so now I'm cloned. But I don't want, you know, it left that one there, but I don't want it to drag like this, because I want it to be cleaner. So when that's the case, you know, in advanced mode is when I do my cloning, and then it's nice and easy. And like, let's say that this angle, which is not quite right, no worries. I come back over here to the ball joint, and I just move the ball joint over, which so sometimes requires a couple extra moves, but now we're nice and clean. In advanced mode, if you're holding a support, like so let's say I've got the support, I'm holding it, and I hit Alt-D, it's going to take the support out of my hand and put it back where it was. It will clone it, it just puts it right back where it was, though. And sometimes, as you can see, it can be a little bit hard to grab it. When that's the case, just use the widget, and then you can move it. In classic mode, though, let's say, you know, so I've dropped that support there, and we move it, you notice there's no line there. If I'm holding and I hit Alt-D, it clones it back in spot. We can see the wireframe there, but leaves it in my hand. So you can drop, pick up, clone, drop, pick up, clone, and that's just a fast way to clone in classic mode. Anyways, I hope this was helpful.